Hello, hi friends, my name is Nilesh. In this video, we are going to see how to automate the subtitles for YouTube. So let's get started. In the previous video, which was part one of this, we looked at what are the different things which are required for uploading the video subtitles to YouTube. So we started with understanding the manual process where we generate the subtitles in the native language, which is English for my case. We download the subtitles file, and then in the manual process, I was using the online subtitles translator for every language that I wanted to support to upload this subtitles file and then download the zip file and then again go into the YouTube studio and add the language and the translated subtitles file. So in part one, we looked at how we can automate the process of generating the subtitles file. So we used the Azure translator for this, and we built a small command line utility which can be used to translate a subtitle file, starting with the one downloaded from the original video in English into multiple languages. So we converted or we translated the file into almost 40 different languages, and this was the configured number of languages. In today's video, we are going to take it one step forward. So instead of going and manually adding all those files to the YouTube video, we will see how we can programmatically upload those subtitles to the YouTube file or to the YouTube video. To get started with this, let's look at what is the prerequisite. So we will be programmatically uploading the file or the subtitles to YouTube. And to get started, we need access to the YouTube data API. This allows us programmatic access to various features of YouTube. And to get started with the YouTube data API itself, we need a Google account. Once we have the Google account, the next step is to create a project in the Google Developers Console, which is the online portal where we can create multiple projects. And then for that particular project, we need to add the authentication and authorization features. We need to have the credentials which will allow us to securely access the features of the Google Data API. And then we also need the client library. So let me quickly switch to the browser and let's have a look at where we can find all this information. So here, I will provide these links in the description of the video. We have to have the access to Google or YouTube Data API. And this getting started page gives us all the steps which are required. So there are four or five different steps, or six different steps here, which are mentioned, starting with having a Google account, then creating a project, obtaining the authorization credentials. And then we go into the API console and we create the secure key. Along with this, I won't be going through each and every step of this. So this documentation is very well done. You can just follow the steps what are mentioned in the documentation, and you can create the project, you can get the key. Everything is very well documented. So along with these steps, you also find that there are quick starts provided in Android, app scripts, Go, iOS, Java, JavaScript, Node.js, all these supported languages. We can get the client library using which from these programming languages we can call the YouTube data API. So I'll show here quickly the JavaScript or Java quick start, and we can see that it supports Java 1.7 or above, and the example shown here is built using Gradle, but you can use Maven as well. And then it gives us the steps to get the client secret and the client ID using OAuth 2, a JSON file which needs to be downloaded. So we need to have the OAuth token, which is required to connect and get the API key. And then there is also a sample project provided. And in the online portal, there is also a facility where we can generate code for any of these supported languages. So to get started with data API, it is quite straightforward and it's quite easy. Only thing I'll show here is how to get the API keys. So once we have the project created here in the console, We can go and create a project here saying new project. I have already created a project named YouTube Subtitles Uploader. So once the project is created, we need to add the data API, YouTube data API, to this project. And then in the credentials, we can create credentials, and this one will give us the client ID. This client ID we need to download and we need to use it in our code. So let me switch to the code, and before I switch to the code version, so if we look at the data API supported languages, there are Python, Ruby, etc., but there is no .NET language supported. Luckily for us, there is a .NET API available as well, which is the YouTube data API v3, and this is published separately. I'm not sure why it's not showing in the list of supported languages, but I refer to this .NET API. And now let me switch to the code version. So we will continue in Visual Studio Code, which I was using last time. So in the code, as I said, let me go into the Solution Explorer. We need to download this clientsecret.json file and have it in our code. Now, the code which is uploaded to YouTube does not, the code which is uploaded to GitHub repository of mine does not have this client secret uploaded, because it's something specific to my account. So if you want to reuse this code, please make sure that you create your own client secret JSON and you put it here in the YouTube Subtitles Uploader project. Now, this follows a similar pattern to the subtitles generator that we saw in the last video. We have a folder where all the subtitle translated files are stored, which is translated output. And these are the different languages, starting with Afrikaans, Albanian, Armenian, and various other languages into which we initially translated the subtitle. And we are going to use these same languages to upload them to the YouTube video. So once we have this, the program that is going to actually do the upload is expecting two input parameters. First one is the YouTube video ID. This we can get from YouTube, the video which we want to upload these subtitles for. And second is the file name. This one is used to dynamically generate the name of the file which we will loop through based on those languages. And from the configuration, we read the translation folder. So let me quickly go to YouTube and we can see how we can get the YouTube video ID. So every video that is uploaded to YouTube, it has a unique ID. This is the ID. If we go to YouTube Studio, after the video, we can find a video ID. Or if we publish the video to the channel, from the channel also we can get the same ID. So when we try to share the link to the YouTube video, you will find this ID available in the YouTube video URL. So take this YouTube video ID, and this is what we will use. So this is the same video for which I generated the titles last time. So I will upload those subtitles using this demo. And what I've done here is using the Visual Studio feature, which allows us to debug the program and set the command line parameters. I have set these two parameters. First one is the name of the ID or YouTube video ID. And second one is the name of the file. Test with RB headset is the name of the subtitles generated file. And then we will append that file name with the language. And then we get the .vtt file, which is the subtitle in that particular language. Then we call the add video caption by passing all this video ID, language code, language name, and the file name. So what this add video caption feature does, or the function does, is it builds the credentials. And all these classes, user credentials, as well as Google Web Authorization Broker, we get this by referencing the YouTube v3 data API. So I've added references to the YouTube v3 data API, and because of those references, we get access to these classes. So we read the contents of that clientsecret.json, and then we build the authorization. We create credentials using Google Client Secrets from that stream. We pass different scopes here, and we use the user as the mode for authentication and authorization to that v3 API. Then we build a YouTube service client, and there is a slight mismatch in the way the languages, language codes are stored between the Microsoft Translator and the languages which are used on YouTube Studio. So in this case, for those languages where there is a slight difference, I'm using a mapping again. So originally ZHHANS was the language code used for the simplified Chinese in Microsoft Translator, whereas Google uses ZH-CN as the language code, and same thing for the Portuguese. The second part of the Portuguese language is capitalized, and that's the reason we have to do this mapping, so that when we upload the translated file in YouTube, it takes the correct language. And then we create the snippets, the caption snippets, and we read the complete contents of that translated file, subtitle file, from the location where we stored the translated subtitles. And then we use this YouTube service instance that we created to insert the caption into YouTube. And finally, we do the upload process in the async manner. So with this, we saw that we build the YouTube client, the service client, and we use that client to upload the captions. And this we do in a loop. So whatever languages we have in our configuration, all those languages, the translated subtitles for those will be uploaded to YouTube. So let's see a quick demo of this. In my translated folder, let's do a quick check that we have the input files ready. So here I have these various files translated in different languages, and I'm going to read this and upload them all the way to YouTube. So let me start this in debug mode, and we will see that the upload process will be triggered. So it's building the project, and once the build is successful, we should see that the files which are uploaded, the names of those files would be output on the console window. So we see the output of the input file name, or name of the file which is used as the input file name. And then for each language, we will use the translated file with this file name. So now we should see the output of each of the file, or a message saying that this particular language file has been uploaded to YouTube. So here we can see that once the file is uploaded, we get this message saying the file with the Spanish subtitles, Hungarian, Hindi, Turkish, and Arabic subtitles have been uploaded. And this will be done for all those languages which we have configured in the application configuration file. So now let me switch back to the presentation, and we can see what did we do. So this is the summary of the whole automation process. So in the first step, we generate the subtitles, we download it. There is no change in this process in the manual as well as automated way. We still need the original language subtitle, which in my case is the English. Then the process of translating it and uploading it has been automated using two command line utilities. So the first command line tool, or first command line utility, both of these are developed in .NET Core, and the first one translates all the subtitles into different languages which are again configured. And then the second utility, which is used for uploading, it uses the YouTube data API, and it reads all these translated subtitles files and uploads them to YouTube. So with this automated process, I have saved almost 1 day of manual effort, and I hope that it really helps to reduce the manual things. You can use this. This code is published on GitHub. There are things which you need to provision yourself. One, which is the API key for the translator, and second is the credentials to connect to the YouTube API. With these two, you would be able to use this if you want to use the same automation for your YouTube channel or for any other translation. The translation that I showed here, it is specifically for YouTube, but the first command line utility can be used for any translation for that matter. It is not just for YouTube. I'm using it for YouTube purpose. You can use it for your own. And the second one is specific to uploading the subtitles files for YouTube. So with this automation, I'm saving a lot of time and effort. There is still a slight gotcha in the second one, where sometimes the file or the message says that the file has been uploaded successfully to YouTube, but there could be some translation problem, or I don't know what is the exact reason, the actual file doesn't get uploaded, and I'm trying to fix this, but because of the time constraints, I'm not able to give enough time. In case you want to have a quick look at the source code and you want to help fixing that issue, please go ahead and do that. So before we close down, let's go and check one more thing, which is I showed you the output on the command line, but let's verify that the subtitles are actually uploaded, because if the subtitles are not uploaded to the YouTube channel, then all this is of no use. So I'm going to refresh the video, the details of this video, and especially the subtitles or the translations related to that video. And what I'm expecting is, initially we had just the automated translation and the English translation applied to this video. Now with the upload, I'm expecting that all those languages that we translated, they are also available here. And there we can see that we have Japanese, Bangla, Finnish, Swedish, German, Polish, and various other language subtitles have been uploaded. And these have been uploaded today, 24th of August, when I'm recording this video. So that's it. We have the proof that we can use this command line utility to automatically upload, or to programmatically upload, the subtitles to a YouTube video file. So once again, I hope that you find this useful. In case you find this video useful, please hit the like button. That is what motivates me to do such kind of videos and help share my knowledge with the rest of the audience. And not just the video, if you find the content, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching this video.